So I think
Is it
it is.
okay?
Yes, please make it full screen.
Okay.
So you are welcome to present your study.
Okay, thank you very much for this organization and giving me the chance to present our presentation, and good evening for everyone. Good evening to everyone. Our presentation is about second order set of equations, and we proposed a new method for this, and I will talk about this. First, I will explain one article about this problem. It's about Stewart Gulf platform, but it can also used in any set of equations. Then I will talk about the Bezout method and our proposed method, and I will give some numerical example from both Bezout method and our proposed method, and the comparison. I would like to start with Stewart platforms. As here you can see, Stewart Gulf platforms are used as simulators. This first figure is from Stewart. He proposed this flight simulator in 1965. Later, Gulf offered this tire test simulator, like in this second figure. And later, after this, some new versions of flight simulators occurred. And today we can see modern version of flight simulator. And these are called Stewart Gulf platform. They are also used in robotic surgery or car simulators. So these are Stewart platforms, shortly. Stewart platforms can be described like two platforms, as you can see here. And these legs are changing over time to change the orientation. In this article, the kinematic equations are described, and later it is shortly by found these three nonlinear equations. These are from this article, these equations. To solve these nonlinear equation set, the author of this article, Nana, offered using Bezout method, Bezout elimination method. In his article, he proposed this determinant first, then after getting this coefficient, you derive this fourth order polynomial, and then by getting this, you get another determinant, and by getting this determinant, you get a 16 degree polynomial, this polynomial, and by solving this polynomial and finding the roots, you can find the Stewart platform configuration. And based on the polynomial, there are many solutions for this. These solutions are give us the combination of platform space. There are different positions for this. So this is an important issue in parallel robots literature. This is called as forward kinematics. And in his article, he found that two of the roots are real numbers and others are imaginary, for this example only. But to explain the Bezout method, we can we can start by these three equations. If we drive, if we change the or if we change the orders here, we can write these equations. Then, taking first and second equations, as I described earlier, we can derive this determinant, and after getting the determinant here, we can get this polynomial that based on nu over power 4. And inside these coefficients, there are these are functions of lambda, another unknown function. So, but to get this determinant, these are the steps to follow. How can we write this determinant? Because of limited time, I will skip this part. And this is the second. This is the first, and this is the second determinant. These are a bit tedious manipulation with mathematics, so I will skip this. But as we can derive this last polynomial by getting this determinant. This is a polynomial of 16th degrees, as I described earlier. So this is based on lambda, and by getting the roots of this polynomial, we can find the roots. So it is it gives us the orientation of our robot. So our proposed method is much simpler than this technique. We first take the equation 4 here. From equation 4, we can derive this mu by the simplest second order equation formula here, and by getting by taking equation 6, we can derive nu like this minus b plus minus discriminant over 2a. As we know, this is the analytical form. So after getting this mu and nu, we can put these value these equations in equation 5 here, because these are only based on these are only a function of mu and nu. And we get from here. So after, on the next page, yes, we can shorten mu like this and nu like this. Actually, there are two versions, two variants for mu and two variants for nu, because this also has a minus here. Sign also here minus sign, but this doesn't change the last polynomial at the end. It gives the same polynomial at the final step. So we will choose this variant at first, and we can take P like this, Q as described here. As shortened given here, and by replacing mu and nu in equation 5, as I said earlier, we derive this. As we can see, it's to get to get another equation, we can multiply both sides of this equation by r square, w square. So we get this equation here. And as we can see, there is a square, this term here and this term here. So to be able to get rid of these terms here, we can write as this formula here, formula 15. To be able to get this term here, we can write like this equivalently, and we can square of equation 16, and we can get this equation by getting another square of this equation. We can get this term is squared, so we can derive at the final stage this formula here, not formula, equation. And this equation, equation 18, is a 32nd order polynomial. We can find this by following these orders here. The maximum order of A is lambda over 8, B is like this, etc. And these definitions here are written here, and we can see that A over 4 is a function of lambda over 32. So this is the maximum, and also here this is the maximum power of this polynomial. So we can say it's a 32 degree polynomial. Here is the programming codes to get the coefficients. And we can derive this polynomial here by getting the roots of this polynomial. We can derive the same, not the same, similar roots to find the orientation of the robot.
2 minutes left.
Excuse me?
You have last 2 minutes.
Okay, here is a numerical example from Bezu method. Here we can find the roots here. These are 2 minutes. Okay, we describe lambda as unknown here, but first we know this. We derive this example as. And we can find lambda here, but there are also other roots that they are also correct for the polynomial. This is using Bezu method, and this is our proposed method. We can find the same roots here. And here is the comparison solution for using Bezu method and our proposed method. Here is the real solution, and the other solutions are also correct for the others, as we can see in the table. My references is here. Thank you for your attendance. And I can say that our method is much simpler than Bezu method to be implemented for practical area. Any questions and comments? Thank you for your
Well, thank you, Professor Dizgin, for your nice presentation. Is there any question or comments about this talk?